students, today I am going to start the new topic of chapter number 3, that is motion in a straight line, and this is episode number 4, which is in continuation with my episode number 3, and the topics which will be covered today are the relative velocity and the motion of the body under gravity, and the third one is the analysis of the motion of the equation of the motions with the help of different types of graphs. And the different types of graphs are the distance time graph, the displacement time graph, speed time graph, velocity time graph, and the acceleration time graph. Here one thing which is very important to note is that in case when we are plotting the graph, the velocity time graph and the speed time graph, the speed and velocity have the same sense. So now coming to the topic. This relative velocity. So what is this relative velocity? The relative velocity of an object 2 with respect to object 1 when both are in motion is the rate of change of position with time of object 2 with respect to object 1. So now suppose this is a body 1 and this is moving with a velocity v1, and there is another body 2 and this is moving with the velocity v2. So suppose the position coordinates of the two objects are x1 0. x1 0 is the one position coordinate, and the x2 0 is the position coordinate of body 2. x1 0 is the position coordinate of body 1. This is at time at t is equal to 0 and t is equal to 0. Now at time t, the position, their position coordinate will be, so after time t their position coordinate will be the position coordinate of body 1, that is x1t is equal to x1 0 plus v1t. This is from equation number first, and the position after time t of body number 2 will be given by x2t, and this is x2 0 plus v2 into t. This is equation number 2. Now on subtracting equation number 1 from equation number 2, on subtracting equation number 1 from equation 2, what we will get, this x2t minus x1t is equal to x2 0 minus x1 0 plus v2 minus v1 into t. So this is on subtracting equation 1 from equation 2, and this will give x2t minus x2 0. On transposing this x2 on the left hand side, we will get this x2t minus x2 0 minus x1t minus x1 0 is equal to v2 minus v1 into t. And
This is the displacement of object 2 in time t. This is the displacement of object 2 in time t. And this is the displacement of object 1 in time t. And the relative displacement of the object, or we may call it the relative displacement. This is total is the relative displacement of the object 2 with respect to 1. And this is equal to v2 minus v1 upon t. And when we will divide this by t, then what we will get? The relative velocity of this will give the, when we will divide this t, divide this value of left hand side with the t, then we will get the relative velocity of object 2 or body 2 with respect to object 1, and this will be equal to v2 minus v1. So now we will get that this v21 is equal to v2 minus v1, or this we may call it the velocity of 2 with respect to 1 is equal to the velocity of 2 minus velocity of 1. Similarly we can write this v12 is equal to v1 minus v2. This v12 indicates that this is the velocity of 1 with respect to velocity 2 and equal to v1 minus v2. Now case first, when v1 is equal to v2, the objects move with the same direction. Case first, when v1 is equal to v2, when both the bodies are moving with the same velocity and in the same direction, then v2 minus v1 will be equal to 0. So the relative velocity will be 0. And when v2 is greater than case second, when v2 is greater than v1, so v2 minus v1 will be positive. And case third, when v2 is lesser than v1, v2 is less than v1, then v2 minus v1 will be negative. So in general form, we can say that if A and B are two bodies, then VAB is equal to VA minus VB. So this is the relative velocity of A with respect to B. Now coming to the next topic, that is the motion under gravity or free fall of the body. Free fall of the body. So now when a body is released from a certain height, it is accelerated. Accelerated means the speed is increased. And this, when it is falling freely from the top from a certain height, then its speed is increased downward under the influence of the force of gravity. And in the absence of air resistance, if there is no air resistance, then all bodies fall with the same acceleration near the surface of the earth. So this motion of the body falling towards the earth, so the motion of the body falling towards the earth from a small height is called the free fall. The acceleration with which the body falls is called the acceleration due to gravity, and it is denoted by small g. This is acceleration due to gravity, and near the earth surface g is taken as 9.8 meter per second square. Now there are two conditions. So now there are two conditions of free fall. When a body is released from a certain height, and that is the downward motion. For downward motion, the equation of motions will be v is equal to u plus gt, h is equal to ut plus half gt square, and v square is equal to u square plus 2gh. Here we have put h in place of s and g in place of a. In the case of when the body is coming falling freely from a certain height, or when a body is thrown from the earth upward, so for upward motion, the equation of motions will be v is equal to u minus gt, because in the downward motion g is taken as positive, and in the upward motion the g is taken as negative. v is equal to u minus gt, and h is equal to ut minus half gt square, and v square is equal to u square minus 2gh. So these are the three equations when the motion is downward, and these are the equations for the motion of upward, for the upward motion. And now one thing which is important: when the body is just dropped from a certain height, then u is taken as u is equal to zero, means its initial velocity will be zero when the body is just dropped from a certain height. Now coming to the next point, that is analyzing the equation of motion, yeah, motion of the body, analyzing the motion of body through different types of graphs. Now we will analyze the equation of motion of the body through the different types of graphs. So there are three types of graphs, that is velocity, that is distance time graph, or you may call it displacement time graph. Second is velocity time graph, or the speed time graph, and the third one is acceleration time graph. So now in all the three cases we will take this time along the x-axis, distance or displacement along the y-axis. In this case we will take time along the x-axis, velocity or speed along the y-axis. In the case of acceleration time graph, we will take the time along the x-axis and the acceleration along the y-axis. So now coming to the graph one by one, that is the distance time graph. So distance time graph analyzing the nature of motion from various graphs. So different types of distance time graph. So now this is a distance time graph where the the time is taken along the x-axis, distance is taken along the y-axis. Now, this is for a body at rest. When the body is at rest, the distance time graph is a straight line parallel to the time axis. जब body rest में होगी तो distance time graph जो होगा वो that will be parallel to the time axis. Now for a body moving with uniform speed, the distance time graph is a straight line inclined to the angle inclined to the time axis at an angle theta. So this is a distance time graph and this is a straight line for a body moving with the uniform speed. This is inclined at an angle theta. For a body moving with accelerated motion means the speeding up. मतलब the speed is increased. The distance time graph is a curved bending upward. So this will be a curved like structure. And this is bending upward. This is for the body moving with accelerated motion. And for a body moving with decelerated motion, अगर speed हमारी down हो रही है, decrease हो रही है, then the distance graph will be a curved graph bending downward. Now coming to the next, that is different types of velocity time graph. Here in this case we have taken velocity along the y-axis and time along the x-axis, and this is the graph for a body moving with uniform velocity. Suppose a body is moving with a uniform velocity, the velocity time graph is a straight line parallel to the time axis, like this AB. AB is shown in the figure and this is a straight line parallel to the time axis. For a body starts from rest and moving with uniform acceleration, its velocity time graph is a straight line inclined to the time axis. So this is a curve and this is a velocity time graph. When a body starts from rest, that is from zero, and uniform acceleration, so this will be a straight line. For a body does not start from rest, agar koi body start rest se start nahi ho rahi hai and moving with a initial velocity u, so suppose it is moving, we have taken this velocity along the y axis, so this the body is moving from start moving from the velocity u. So at point A the velocity is u and the velocity time graph is a straight line inclined to the time axis. For a body moving with non-uniform acceleration, so the velocity time graph will be curved bending upward. This is the case of increasing acceleration. Now for a body moving with non-uniform acceleration, non-uniform acceleration, decreasing non-uniform acceleration or decreasing non-uniform velocity, its velocity time graph is a curved bending downward. So this is like this, it is bending downward. And for a body starts with an initial velocity u, the velocity decreases uniformly with time, becoming zero after some time. Its velocity time graph represents negative acceleration. So this is showing the negative acceleration and is a straight line and has a negative slope. This is having a negative slope. For a body projected upward, अगर हम किसी बॉडी को ऊपर की तरफ प्रोजेक्ट कर रहे हैं विद एन इनिशियल वेलोसिटी यू, द वेलोसिटी डिक्रीजेस विद टाइम, तो वेलोसिटी इसकी धीरे धीरे कम होती जाएगी. एंड नेगेटिव विद नेगेटिव यूनिफॉर्म, इट इज नोन एज नेगेटिव यूनिफॉर्म एक्सेलरेशन, बिकमिंग जीरो आफ्टर सर्टेन टाइम, द वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ विल बी लाइक दिस. एंड फॉर ए बॉडी मूविंग विद वेरिएबल एक्सेलरेशन, the area between the velocity time graph and the time axis gives the displacement. So velocity time graph will be like this. This is coming upward, going downward, then coming upward. Now different types of speed time graph. For a body projected upward, agar koi body hum upar ki taraf dekhte hain, the speed time graph is of the type shown in the figure. And the speed decreases uniformly, becomes zero at the highest point. As the body moves down, its speed increases uniformly, it returns with the same speed with which it was throwing up. So this is very important point that for a body projected upward, जब किसी body को हम upward project करते हैं, the speed time graph will be like this and the speed decreases uniformly becoming zero, और ये धीरे धीरे decrease करती है और zero हो जाती है, and at the highest point as the body moves down, और जब highest point पे पहुंचने के बाद velocity जब zero हो जाती है, then it starts moving coming downward. So as the body moves down, its speed increases uniformly. फिर से speed जो है वो इसकी uniformly increase करती है, and it returns with the same speed with which it was throwing up. So the graph will be like this. And for a body dropped upward, for a ball dropped on the ground from a certain height, अगर किसी certain height से हम drop करते हैं किसी ball को, the speed time graph is of the type shown in the figure like this, and as the ball falls its speed increases, as the ball bounce back its speed decreases uniformly and becomes zero at the highest point. So the graph will be like this. Now different types of acceleration time graphs. So the different types of acceleration time graph, we have taken acceleration along the y-axis and time along the x-axis. Now for a body moving with constant acceleration, the acceleration time graph is a straight line parallel to the time axis. अगर कोई body constant acceleration से move कर रही है, the graph will be AB parallel, which is parallel to the time axis. When the acceleration of a body increases uniformly, अगर कोई body में acceleration uniformly increase हो रहा है, then the acceleration time graph is a straight line inclined to the time axis as shown in the figure. For a body moving with variable acceleration, suppose there is a variable expression, kabhi acceleration jyada ho raha hai aur kabhi jo hai wo kabhi speed badh rahi hai kabhi speed down ho rahi hai, then the acceleration time graph is a curve. The area between the acceleration time graph and the time axis gives the change in velocity, and the graph will be like this. So this is the end of the topic and end of the chapter. Now you have to complete the notes of this chapter and send me in the group. Thank you very much.